calificas para ser legal. ¿Quieres saber? Solo llama al abogado Andrés Mejer.
DACA, what happened? What's going on? So first, little history lesson. What is DACA? DACA is protection from deportation. It gives you work authorization if you meet certain qualifications. Obama announced it in 2012, so some 7 years ago. Trump in September 2017 said, you know what? I'm gonna eliminate it. And he signed an order saying it's gone. And multiple courts have said, oh, hold on a second. I don't agree with you. Now, very important. No court has said that I'm aware of that Trump doesn't have the ability to eliminate DACA. He does. What a president giveth, another president can taketh away. So there's no question that the president, any president, has that right. The issue is, how did they go about doing it? By making all of his comments and his tweets made it seem like it might have been discriminatory. It's about process. You need to follow the process. Anybody who's had my firm defend you in a criminal charge knows about the process, because that's how we win most cases. It isn't often whether you ran that red light or not. It isn't whether you were speeding or not, or whether you were driving drunk. Yes, that is the state's burden, but the state needs to prove it according to the law. In Trump context, in the DACA context, Trump needed to publish a rule in the Code of Federal Regulations. So he needed to first say, hey, we're looking to change DACA. Give us your comment, get a comment, then revise it and provide a final rule, which will be implemented at some time. None of that happened. He just said, gone. This is gonna be heard by the Supreme Court. There's gonna be oral arguments in November. What happened last week? Lawyers for the Department of Justice that represent the White House and this administration said that DACA is at best legally questionable and at worst is illegal. That was their position. They eliminated it because they didn't have any faith in its legality. Now, there's a number of court opinions that have said DACA is legal. Important note, when Obama wanted to expand DACA, and Judge Andrew Haven in Texas stopped it. How did he stop it? Because Obama didn't follow the process. It's the same arguments that others have made against Trump. So what's going to happen? We don't know. We will have to see whether what the Supreme Court will say. Are they going to protect DACA or are they not? We're going to hear oral argument in November. We will likely get a decision before June 2020. So it will be an election issue, no matter what the outcome is. Now, very important, if you have DACA, if you're charged with a crime, you need to consult with an immigration attorney. Period, end of story. I have a client I'm meeting with tomorrow, made an appointment with me, and he said, listen, I had DACA, but I got pulled over, I was drunk, I told the judge I was drunk, he convicted me of DUI, and then I was denied my DACA. What do I do? Well, only thing to do in that scenario is go and look at, did you have a way to beat your DUI? Because it's a bright line rule. You're convicted of DUI, you're automatically barred from DACA. Same thing if you have a domestic violence charge or a drug possession. Automatic denial of DACA. So you can't have that on your record. We need to look at post-conviction relief to reopen it. First conviction is typically loss of license anywhere from 3 months to 12 months. It doesn't matter to immigration. Conviction is a conviction, period. So the gentleman who I'm meeting with tomorrow, we're going to be looking at his options for post-conviction relief. His appeal period has lapsed, so we're going to look, is there a fundamental constitutional issue in the way that his case was prosecuted, to see is there an avenue to reopen it. My name is Andres Mejer. I'm an immigration attorney author, and speaker, and I'm an immigrant. If there's something you want us to talk about in the future, indicate it below. I'm happy to do it. Parole in place and the whole consular process all came out of your questions and comments. I welcome them. Thank you very much. Until next week.